So how do I do that? How do I upload my files to FedSEP? All right, so you go to FedSEP, sign into your sign-in, your approved registration sign-in, and then you're going to select Form 462. Before we actually upload the files, let me show you the home Form 462 home here. Notice down here, there's a communications section. This is where we're going to put new announcements. For example, there's a new Excel tool or a new version of the tool that you need to actually download and import your data from one version to the new version before you try to generate your XML, okay? It's also the case that if we for some reason or another have an extension, we would put that extension information here on the website for your information. So what do we do to, how do we upload our files? We click on Complaint Data Upload. All right, that brings us to this screen right here. And you can see there are two file types, Excel and the XML. So let's upload our Excel file first. Remember, we have to upload two files. You always want to make sure that the files you upload are actually married. In other words, the XML file you upload is the file that the Excel XLSM tool you utilized to generate that XML. So don't upload an Excel XLSM file that you did last week, but you generated the XML file from a new tool you've populated this week. Make sure that the two are married together. Okay, so we're going to browse. Click the Browse button. We're going to find our XLSM tool. We're going to say yes, and then we're going to click this cool little button over here that says Upload File. Okay, that's how quick that was. And we can see that it's been received. Now notice over here, under the action column, there's this red circle with a white minus sign in it. That gives you the opportunity to delete the file if you, in fact, realize you've grabbed the wrong version of the file, okay? Or you just don't want to submit yet, all right? All you have to do is click that button and then confirm that deleting the document is what you want to do. In this case, I don't want to delete it. So now I'm going to upload my XML file, okay? Be sure that you move and click the type of file you're actually going to upload. I'm going to browse. I'm going to upload this XML file, click Open, and click Upload File. Now this file's a little larger, takes a little longer, not too long, to upload. Notice once I did that, now underneath the Upload File button, and right above the Actions tab, I have a button that's called Process. In order for my files to be reviewed by EEOC, I've got to process them, okay? So I click the Process button, and you can see that my status now on these two files has gone from received to validating data. So what's happening is the portal is actually checking to ensure that the format of those two files, there's no hiccups in, there's no bleeps in, so that it can read the files correctly, all right? The problem with this particular screen, and something we're working on, is the status will not update while you're sitting here looking at this page, all right? So what you have to do is go to another page and then work your way back to the complaint data upload. Ah, so it's finished looking at the data. Now it says it's loading the data. We're almost there. As you can see, some of the files underneath have a data loading successful. That means that our report is finally ready for our EEO director to certify this year. So we're still loading data here. We're going to go back off a different link, a different page, go back here, and we see we are now successful. So what that means is the EEO director can now log in to the FedSEP portal and actually certify the report so that EEOC can begin its review. You want to make sure for this year's report that the EEO director, actually has certified the report, giving EEOC a few days to make sure that everything is good in the report before it's accepted. If the EEOC does not accept the report, you'll get a feedback email, just like you're used to, from the form462.form462 email that tells you what data pieces you need to look at again. Okay, so let's log out of here and log in as the EEO director again, and we'll see what the EEO director has to do before EEOC will actually review the file this year. And I think I kind of skipped over the fact that for this year, you want to make sure that the report is accepted by EEOC
before the October 31st deadline.
All right, so I've logged in. I have to select my agency. I'm the EEO director now. Now see, the EEO director has a registration management page. The EEO director has the guidance link that you as a preparer also had. They have the Form 462 with its drop-down, and they have the MD-715, which right now is not available on the portal for use because we're working hard to get these 462 reports done, right? So what we're going to do is the EEO director, they're going to come down here and look at or click on this certification and status link. All right. And what they see is they have two reports out here that they need to certify. Okay? No EEO director in their right mind is going to certify a report without being able to see it first, right? So this is what they do. See how this has a line underneath it, and as I hover to it, it becomes a link. Up here, it doesn't, so my aggregate report is not ready for review yet. But if I click on this link for my sub-agency report and give the portal a minute or two, it's going to generate this report for me that I can now open and review. Okay? To make sure that all of the data is correct, accurate, there's nothing missing, the comments are correctly filled out. And then all I have to do, if I'm satisfied with that, is certify. When I click the certify button, you can see that by clicking yes, the EEO director is in fact certifying that the data for this year's report is accurate and complete. Okay? All right, so if I click yes, you can see now that the status has changed from pending EEO director certification to pending EEOC review. Remember, this status has to be accepted by EEOC, not pending our review
before the October 31st deadline.
One of the things I wanted to point out as we looked at this report, one of the new features this year when we look at our PDFs, is in the footer. Down here in the footer on every page now in the report, you'll find the actual report status and the date and time that it went to that status. All right? So we know that ZZ2 Test Agency's report is now pending EEOC's review. It says the report is finalized. As a parent agency or an independent agency with no subcomponents, this is the status that you want to see in the footer of your report. This means your report has been accepted by EEOC, and this is the date and the time that we will use to determine timeliness and report to Congress this year. If we take a look at the historical report here, we can see that the XLSM file that I just uploaded today is sitting here. And this is actually for your convenience, so that if for some reason or another you well, not you. You have done your job. You've submitted it. The EEO directors approved it. And you're off on vacation because you want to make sure you don't lose any of your use or lose leave for this year. So what happens is EEOC's review finds that, oops, we got a bad number, okay? Somebody's got to go in and fix that. By putting this document, holding this document here, somebody else that has access for this agency can then come in and actually download this tool, make the correction, regenerate the XML file, and then resubmit. No problems.